Welcome to another replay. Oh, not replay, no. It's a general thing. It's about ranked and what I don't like about the current state. I tried to approach it in the topic in a reasonable manner, explaining the mode. Yeah, it's a 7 versus 7 mode in which 7 random players play against 7 random players. The matchmaking is like in randoms, it doesn't account for radar ships or anything else. It's simply a 7 versus 7 random mode where you can reach ranks by winning games or saving your rank by keeping a star. It is announced by Wargaming as competitive, but I don't agree on that too much right now. So yeah. I think clan battles is a way, way better competitive mode. So, what I personally don't like about the current state of the ranked game mode. That's all about this. I will explain what I don't like, and then I will also bring up some possible solutions. I'm not sure. I mean, if someone from Wargaming watch this, maybe you consider it. If not, well, I need to get some yeah, relief from all this stuff I see in raid once in a while. Okay, first of all, everybody is allowed to play ranked battles if he owns at least one tier 10 ship. That's the thing where it already begins. It doesn't matter how many games someone played or what win rate someone has. And for a competitive game mode, or for a point of view which is competitive, I don't agree that this is a good idea. Yeah, I also know people will argue that win rate doesn't matter, but I'm pretty sure that solo win rate, for example, as an indicator, is a absolutely significant value and can't be underrated. In my eyes, it's ridiculous if people have 45% win rate overall and play ranked battles. I mean, they just prove, or have proven, that they simply have a negative impact on the game or on the team they are playing with. If they are 50%, they are neutral. Of course, over statistical relevant number. But if you have 45%, you have proven that you aren't have a positive impact on your team at all. And I don't get why someone is allowed to play ranked battle with such values. I can accept that it's in randoms like this, because random is random, and it's how it is, right? So nothing too bad. But it's incomprehensible for me that someone has access to a so-called competitive game mode and has a from the start on a negative impact on the game. It's more like if you start the battle, you just hope that you don't have too many of these players in your team, because then your win or chances to win are way, way higher than they would be in you know what I mean, I guess. Furthermore, the level of frustration for players that have at least a decent win rate is enormous at the moment. And I mean, it might be subjective, but on the other hand, I assume that from listening to a lot of people in my environment, that whom the majority of them is or has at least a decent win rate. I know that ranked was never a fun mode to play, because it always leads a bit to frustration, and because you have, especially when you try to play for the win, then you have always people that do exactly the opposite, and that's quite so. If they do it intentionally, it's a different thing, but it's a bit frustrating. And on tier 10, this even more increases. Even though I can accept that the ships on tier 10 are okay-ish balanced, except for the CVs that have, in my opinion, a way too high influence, if well played, of course. If you have a bad player, that's bad. But normally you can't help your team at all. If you're in a normal ship and not in a CV, and you don't, you're just dependent on your carrier a lot. So that's why I accept or exclude CVs from this. Nothing else. And therefore, I think also tier 10 is not the right tier for ranked at the moment. Number one reason is the strength of the ships itself. A good player can sustain quite a while under fire, while a bad player gets punished pretty hard when doing mistakes. And should it be like this? In my opinion, no. Because the gap, the skill gap, is increasing the stronger the ships that are available are actually. And on other tiers, for example tier 6, tier 8, it's not the case. It's less punishing, but you can still do very well if you're a decent player. So that's why I don't think tier 10 is such a good rank mode. On the other hand, a very subjectable a thing of my own. I think it's also a bit boring over the time to play only tier 10 all the time. If you want to get the legendary modules for the tier 10s, okay, you have to play tier 10. If you want to play clan battles, you have to play tier 10. If you want to play tournaments like King of the Sea, you have to play tier 10. If you want to play ranked nowadays, you also have to play tier 10. So at some point it's get a bit ridiculous and boring, and it would be great to have a change for a while, like playing tier 8 or whatever, tier 6, never mind, I don't care, but something different would be really, really interesting. Just because this game has a lot of ships that make a lot of fun on different tiers. I'm not talking about the OP ships like Belfast or Kamikaze or whatever you want to call them. It's just simply about that there are definitely some interesting tiers out there that could be also or used as a ranked competitive environment. Alright, that are my two things which I absolutely hate about the rank mode at its current state. So I go over to what, in my opinion, how things could be changed to give all players a better time in ranked. Because I think that's what Wargaming also intends, and I think would make most of the players happy. Also, a side note, it's still my own opinion and only suggestions. I don't think they are like the complete or general truth. It's just the thing. If you play ranked and you play it for a while and you have some approaches, and then you think about what could be done better at some point to make, as I said, the experience for the players a bit more interesting. So first, maybe an addition of some more factors that reward good play. I mean, we have these factors already, so it's not only adding, it's also extend the values of existing factors. So for example, for a battleship, it is, for example, tanking. Or not for example, but definitely tanking. If you tank in a battleship, you're really helpful for your team because you act as a damage sponge. You can still shoot your guns and inflict massive damage, but damage tanking is so much or so good for your team, because then no other ships like cruisers do have to tank normally if they position themselves wisely. As I said, it's a good indicator. If someone tanked like 1.5 to 2 million potential damage in his battleship in a game, which is quite a lot in a 7 versus 7, every potential damage point should be rewarded even more upon this mark. So let's say, I mean, this mark is just like, I just assumed like, okay, let's use the 1.5 to 2 million mark. I mean, you could also say, okay, 1 million potential damage is also fine in a 7 versus 7. And apart, all above that, every potential damage point that you gain is increased, or not increased, but is more valuable to you, because then you can. Torpedoes to starboard. Sorry, I have to watch this because this replay already shows how bad this is. You saw what happened to my Des Moines, but yeah, okay. Yeah, every point should be rewarded even more after this mark, and this mark is of course a thing you have to discuss and maybe statistically prove whatever, what makes sense and so on and so on. But it also, if you increase it, the experience gain from it, it's always a good thing in my opinion, because this rewards good play. For DDs, it could be especially spotting damage. I mean, this is already implemented in the game, but in my opinion, not really rewarded enough. And there has to be a value as well, or it has to be found a value that makes sense. Maybe on average, what the top 20% of the players average on in the ranked seasons, and from there on, take this average value and increase the experience gains for every spotting damage done after that one. So same concept like on the tanking or potential damage, same with the spotting damage. On cruisers, it's a bit different, I think. Maybe there could be a mix, like, of spotting and tanking, since we have ships like a Moskva, Stalingrad, who are really good at tanking damage as well as a cruiser. And then we have ships like the Wooster or Minotaur, who are not good at tanking damage, but really good at spotting with their radar or with their good concealment. So there would be a possibility to reward this as well. A last point, and a new point, is time spent in battle, if you reward this. Yeah, that sounds a bit strange, because people think, okay, that's a bad number, because it's highly abusive. But I don't think so, personally. I see it the other way around. The players that are bad, and just YOLO in for no reason, or by not having any positive effect on the game, it gets even more, or they have a harder time, because at that point they have to be a bit more cautious and don't die in the first 5 minutes of the game, unless they are doing it intentionally. But then they only, anyways, have no aim to get a good experience or whatever. So no competitive behavior at all. And in that reason, it would definitely reward people that at least don't try to die within a or in a glimpse of the battle, which is always a good thing. Because normally I have the issue, that's a personal thing, that my team is dying too quickly, while I could influence the game more in a positive way. In case my team would stay alive a bit longer. Yeah, but this is a controversial thing. I think the key is the mix of these rewarding factors, how you will mix it. This is definitely not an easy task to achieve, but it is definitely worth thinking about, in my opinion at least. Another option would be to separate the player pools, which will be very controversial at which point you cut it, that's for sure. And I'm also not really sure about this, because separating player bases is, I think, a thing that Wargaming doesn't intend to do at all. And I can understand that. They want to encourage the players to play every mode and so on and so on. But let me just clear things up. I would nail it at the, again, solo win rate of the player. And there has to be made a cut in which you separate the players. Since I lack statistical numbers, I would just assume a cut makes sense around the 50% mark, but I also can be wrong, so I'm not really sure about this. I suppose the statistical number would be the median, but I'm really not sure about this. So you have a lower and a higher bracket from where the cut is coming from. The lower bracket can play the same ranks, but get less rewarded, which is justified by their performance, right? So if you want to enter the higher bracket, you have to improve your gameplay to get better rewards. Also, it's logical, in my opinion. So, as an indicator, you can take the, like, before a ranked season, someone is calculating it or just checking the statistics of the player of the last 200 games, how he played there, and how good he was. I mean, of course, this is also abusive, and it's also not easy to achieve, but, yeah, it would be a start, I would say. And yeah, hopefully not such a bad idea. I mean, as I said, I made my mind up, and there can be also different ways of approaching it. But at the moment, I think ranked is just crying for an improvement at all costs. As I said, I'm not a big fan of this, but yeah, maybe others have different opinions. Third and last one, abolish rank completely and create some missions for the players itself. Means we don't have like a random we completely abolish this rank mode, and players get missions that they can fulfill via playing random battles at different tiers, for example. So you can also achieve it by playing tier 8 or tier 6, whatever, that has to be thought through. And of course, originating from the difficulty of the missions, the rewards will be adjusted. So the harder the mission, the better the rewards. Pretty as that, simple as that. You can also make like it in a ranked manner. So you say, okay, for rank 15, you have to do this and this, like do kill 7-8 ships in at least 10 battles or something like that. I don't know, I didn't make my mind up, but that has to be a thing that has to or Wargaming has to think about if they want to change anything. As I said, the state of ranked is right now, I can't consider it competitive at all, and it's rather just a 7v7 random battle mode. And clan battles make so much more fun regarding the competitive aspect of the game that there is no point of having a ranked mode at the current state. So that's the conclusion I have made for myself. Don't know what you think about it. Maybe you have also different ideas. Sorry if I was stuck at some point. I really made here a list. I wrote almost 3 sides of A4 sized paper. Yeah, hopefully was a valuable video to watch. And yeah, maybe you think different, maybe you think the same. You can just leave your opinion in the comments. Would be nice to have a lively discussion there. All right, yeah, thanks for watching, guys, again, and see you next time. Bye bye.